politics right now and everything that's going on with politics, Kamala Harris, Cory Booker, and everything that's going on in the Democratic Party, what are your thoughts?
Politricks, and it's rough, you know, whether it's the Democrats or the Republican, it's, I mean, it's just challenge, you know, to get involved, really. I mean, because everything seems like it's the same flavor with a different label on it.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, we have, I think that as a people, we have invested too much into politics and not enough into spiritual reform and economic reform of our people. We made a big mistake, I believe, in the 60s and the 50s and the 40s fighting for civil rights when we should have been fighting for silver rights.
Yeah.
We should have been doing more independent economic affairs instead of wasting so much time trying to get them to accept us. We had, at the time, before integration, we had black hotels, black cab companies, black bus companies, black restaurants. And as soon as white people said, y'all can come and eat with us and sleep with us and ride in our cars, all of ours went out of business. Integration meant disintegration because we misappropriated into civil rights instead of silver rights. Today, we're doing the same with politics. We are putting too much of our vested interest into electing a benevolent white person into office or a Negro that's going to be the manager of white people's affairs to become the highest position in the land. We need to invest more time in the spiritual development and economic development as a people. So I'm not really personally excited about it. Mm-hmm. Based off the scriptural lens that you use, I've never read in the Bible or Holy Quran where a politician ever freed the people. In fact, every time I read the scripture, the politicians were always in cahoots with the rulers and the kings that were the enemies of the messengers and the prophets. And what we've seen with Rome, Egypt, Babylon, Sodom, and Gomorrah, anytime you got a nation where everything goes, that nation will soon be gone.
That's right. I like what you said about economic empowerment, because I've been reading a lot about Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. You know, I'm reading a lot from his attorney, Dr. William Pepper. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And everybody knows Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. As soon as he made that pivot from civil rights
to silver,
right. That's when he got killed.
That is whenever they killed. And his wife said it.
Mm-hmm.
Before she passed, she said that they killed my Martin because he got involved in economics. See, the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan said like his, he said, business is the activity of life. This is the responsibility of any people. Billie Holiday said like this, that mama may have and papa may have, but God bless a child that has its own. You translate that into spiritual politics or economic. See, the Jews might have, Chinese people might have, but God bless a people that have their own. Right now, do you know we brought in $1.3 trillion last year as a people?
Mm.
Out of 226 nations on the earth, that makes black people in America the eighth richest nation. We brought in $600 billion more than Spain, $700 billion more than Mexico. Yes, Spain has 46 million people like we do, and they maintain a 208,000 square mile landmass, and they have their own everything. Mexico has 131,700,000 people, and they're maintaining 771,500 square miles with half the money we have. Yet they have whole countries, and we don't have nothing we can call on. Something happened to us. We got to get back into what they call today financial literacy. But we got to do it quick, because we got to start doing something for ourselves. We got the dollars. We just need some more sense to go with them dollars.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
We need some more sense, because right now we the leaders in unnecessary spending. We always buying stuff we don't need with money that we don't have from people that we don't like to impress people that we don't even know.
Mm.
And the Negro, the black mind right now has been hardwired where happiness is connected to spending when it needs to be hardwired to investing and into saving. And if we can renegotiate the contract in the black psyche, well, happiness to spending, to investing and saving, I think we'll be able to build a bright future.